So guys, I recently came across this post on Facebook saying that if you're currently 20 to 30 years old and your main circle isn't discussing about opening businesses, investing, escaping the 9 to 5, fitness, and or self-development, then maybe it's time for you to find a new inner circle. Sounds great, right? Pero teka, parang may mali eh. Number 1, it's good to have a support group. But remember that your friends do not dictate the path that you will take or the victories that you will achieve. For those of you who know me, you know that I'm all up for the achievement, growth, winning those small victories. No? But I don't think it's fair for your friends no, na ika-cut off mo lang sila simply because nahihirapan sila na pag-usapan with you yung mga bagay na hindi pa sila komportabling pag-usapan nyo. Like for example, investing, escaping their corporate jobs, especially if they've been living that way and supporting their families through that way for a long period of time already. So I don't think it's fair that you will cut them off simply because they don't want to agree with you that they want to start their own business and start investing soon. Now, I agree na mas madali mong ma-achieve yung mga short-term goals mo tsaka yung mga long-term goals mo if you have a support group that speaks the same language and believes in the same things or principles that you believe in. But this leads me to number 2. Your friends now, your inner circle now, they are there for a reason. And I don't think it's just because you guys believe in the same business or in the same concept of investing. Your friendship has more to it than that, no? So why not just turn the boat of your friendship around, no? If you genuinely think that you have a great idea that will boost you up to success, why not use this to inspire your friends instead of cutting them off and replacing them with people who you think will be better for you? Or else napaka-utilitarian ng dangdating noon, di ba? That you will cut off your friends simply because you don't think they share the same principles as you do. Simply because nahihirapan sila to push themselves to get up every day and exercise. No? Why not inspire them, show them the way to get up and start sweating, work out, diba? To live a life of fitness if you genuinely believe that this will be better for them. So don't leave them just yet. Do your part as a friend. Which brings us to number 3. Remember that the value of your friendship does not only depend on the value that they bring to you. Friendship is a two-way street, no? Dapat merong give and take. May mga pagkakataon na ikaw yung nagbibigay ng tulong, ikaw yung nagbibigay ng opinion mo, ikaw yung nagbibigay ng advice about investing, opening a business, looking for other opportunities, no? Na magiging productive para sa inyo. Pero tandaan mo, may mga pagkakataon din nung ikaw yung nangangailangan ng kausap at yung mga friends mo na yun yung nandyan para sa'yo. So you see, your friendship does not only revolve on ideas about businesses, on ideas about investing. Your friendship with your main circle is about many more things na pinagsamahan ninyo na all throughout those years. Ang susi lang naman dito is to respect. Respect your friends. Inspire each other to be better and be a friend. Don't cut them off just because you guys are not talking about opening a business or you guys are not talking about escaping your 9-to-5 jobs or you're not talking about making more money than you're making now. Dahil kung yung friendship nyo ay dun lang nakasalalay, then I don't think it deserves to be called friendship.